Welcome to the Big Boost. This is Clarity Ross. It's time to go all out, to engage ferociously with truth at this time. You know, going forward, no matter who wins, there's going to be a lot of people in this world extremely unhappy and frustrated because of the polarization that is present. That only adds to the intensity of frustration that's inherent in existence. So therefore, do not place any faith or trust in the future of this planet. You have to find the truth right here and now, right where you are. In every moment, the truth is that that which cannot be touched or tarnished is present in equal intensity with all other moments and all other places. That is a fact. And this is the fact that will set you free. It will set you free from the future, and it will set you free from all the past. And it is this truth that the Big Boost is aiming at. And fortunately, we have this capacity to present these videos to you in a format which is quite interesting and effective. We're doing this broadcast live right now, and I'll put it up on YouTube. You may be watching it on YouTube. But this is all the mixing is being done live. It's all set up ahead of time to mix these various panels here. We are going to focus on this video, in this video, on the guru function. The guru function is that which enables us to be reassured of the fundamental truth that what we truly are, which is endlessness, is untouched right now, and always untouched, equally at this time and all times, equally in this place and all places. That is what the guru brings you. The guru can teach in silence, and we're going to, in this video, practice that silence, because the guru is telling you, showing you, you need not go anywhere. You need not make any movements. You need not make any attempts for truth to be true. The truth is that endlessness cannot be brought to an end. It cannot be touched by anything that arises within it. Everything is arising within endlessness. But what arises in endlessness does not touch or tarnish endlessness at all. Therefore, you don't have to be in any particular place. You don't have to be going any particular place. You don't have to be making any movements or any efforts. You don't have to be trying to grasp it conceptually or not grasp it. The guru has this quality of effortless grace, effortlessness. This is the great reassurance, because we can feel the perfect stability and the perfect non-panic, non-concern, the perfect non-concern of the guru. So let's take a look at one of the greatest gurus, one of the greatest reassurers that's ever been on this planet. And that is Sri Ananda Mahima, who, for the most part, taught in silence, simply sitting.
Thank you.
now, this great guru exemplified complete non-concern. She was in total bliss continuously, without any interruption. Effortless bliss and non-concern at all times. And what this does is it reassures us. We see this, we feel it, and we say, this being has an extraordinary quality about them. It's different than anything that we are used to encountering. Perhaps it's something we've never encountered before, because nothing seems to bother this guru at all. No matter what is happening, there's this absolutely steady unconcern, a quality that doesn't come from our psychology of reactivity. It's an unconcern about being where she is, or where she isn't, or where she may be going or not going, or saying or not saying, or meeting someone or not meeting them, doing this or not doing this. There's just this complete, endless, effortless, unconcerned quality that says, what I am, what my identity is, cannot be touched by anything that arises within it. And this is the great guru. This is the one who shows us this unconcern, who models it for us, who says, look, it's here. It's here right now, and it's here in the exact same quantity and quality as it is any other place. Because you see, she's not concerned about trying to go some other place to get more of it, okay? That's the benefit from seeing the guru. Okay, we're now back. The guru is again sitting, perfect bliss, not trying to go anywhere or do anything. This is the essential quality that conveys to us the all-important truth that we need to acknowledge and to realize. It's being conveyed simply by this simple sitting. We must believe this, and I am explaining this here because it's so all important. why is this being completely happy, effortlessly happy, unconcerned about anything that's going on, unconcerned about what's going on in the world, completely happy sitting there right at that moment without any indication of disturbance, of uneasiness, and of instability, of desire to do something else, to be somewhere else. Zero desire. Let us now once again return to silent sitting. Practice again, realizing what is the guru conveying. Is there some kind of conceptual teaching that's being conveyed? No, it's more than that. It's a reassurance of the omnipresence of truth, that endlessness cannot be touched in any way, cannot be altered or changed or brought to an end in any way, and that endlessness is our identity, that everything that arises in it doesn't touch it in any way. Right here, right now, that fact is true. Wherever you are, where you're watching this, that fact is equally true as to where I'm broadcasting this or anywhere else in the universe or universes. And this moment, this very moment that you're watching it, this is also the equally true in this very moment, as equal as all other moments, both in the past, now, and in the future. It's all equal. So you don't have to go anywhere. You don't have to go into the future or try to go into the past. Think about the past or think about the future. Because it's going to be the same presence then as it is right now. So let's practice this, receiving this conveyance of assurance. Now, as you saw, on the right was the constantly changing earth, the atmosphere, ever moving, everything's being oxidized and chemically being altered constantly in this world. And then the left was the guru, who is sitting there simply on the floor in a simple room, completely blissful, completely unconcerned about any changes that are taking place, knowing that this moment and all moments, the truth is exactly the same. The fact that endlessness can never be brought to an end is exactly the same fact, always. And so the guru knows this for a fact and is completely reassured that nothing can happen to identity. Doesn't matter what changes take place in form or anywhere. Makes no difference. That's why the guru has this complete, blissful unconcern about identity, about their beingness. No worries. Don't have to do anything to protect it, to get more of it. It's equally present, all places, all times. Equally present, equally true. So what does any of us have to do? We don't have to do anything about it. Now we're going to practice again. The guru sitting. And watch very carefully how the guru is so relaxed and not troubled in their mind about needing to do something or go somewhere. So let's try some more of this. Very simple, isn't it? Very simple. Whether somebody is doing something or not doing something doesn't matter. Whether they're placing a flower wreath on the guru or the guru just sitting there simply. Same bliss. Same complete lack of concern for identity. No need to protect it. No need to defend it. No need to do anything to get more of it. It's perfectly present right now. Always present. Every moment there will ever be is equally present. No more and no less than right now. The fullness of it is present right now. The complete fullness of it. It will never be more. It will never be less. Exactly right now. And every moment is exactly the same. The guru knows that every moment, the presence of identity is exactly the same. So why are they concerned about getting to some other moment? They're not. So let us do some more practicing with a slightly different soundtrack. Silent sitting, quiet, relaxed sitting, the unconcerned sitting, not worrying about any moment at all, knowing that all moments, truth is equally present. You notice how completely in the moment she is, each moment the same, same quality. Complete awareness that the all moments. Truth does not need to be enhanced because it's very simple. Nothing can touch endlessness. Endlessness is truth. That is reality. Endlessness is our identity. It is the one identity. There's only one identity, and that's endlessness. All play that arises within endlessness cannot change what endlessness is, because endlessness inherently transcends everything that arises within it. So this fact is always true. The guru simply knows this fact. He's not trying to change this fact. He's not trying to deny it. It's completely clear, 100% clear. Absolute clarity about this one simple fact. And this one simple fact outshines all concerns, because all concerns have to do with believing that somehow endlessness can be touched and changed and brought to an end in some fashion. All concerns come from that, 100% of them. All the arising, all the constructivity, and then the destructivity, all of that is arising in endlessness and doesn't touch it at all. So there's no concern, one way or the other, to do or not to do, makes no difference as far as our identity is concerned. So there's no need to worry that the guru is expecting you to understand some sort of complex teaching, that they're waiting for you. They're not waiting at all. There's no waiting there. They're simply abiding in the one beingness with complete lack of concern. They're simply abiding in that. That's all. They're not expecting you to understand some sort of complex esoteric teaching. Simply radiating reassurance. That's it. It's greater than the conceptual. The reassurance is, yes, right here, right now, the beingness is endless. And everywhere is the same. Great good fortune to find such a being who radiates this reassurance. It's a big boost. It is the big boost. You can feel the reassurance that all is well, everywhere. In all time, there's no problem. No problem with the one identity. Being the endless beingness that it is. Not only in this place, but in all places. Not only in this time, but all time. And this outshines all concern. You don't have to do anything to get rid of concern. It's outshine, just like when you uncover something and let the sun shine upon it. Now let's shift to another sitting, and we'll take this on to the end of the video.